We're here right now. It's the end of the day. We just had lunch. We're digesting our potatoes with butter and little mushrooms from Chernobyl. And now we're here because we're going to see this memorial. But I think there's more over there because, what's his name? Levin designed this whole thing. And it has something to do with the war.
The people who are killing the villages.
Destruction of the shtetl.
Of this door
during the burning.
Yeah, during the burning. И практически их.
And 30 years ago, you had the genius and wisdom to create something that I think we all believe that will survive and last for thousands of years and be as meaningful then as it is today.
30 лет назад мы создали то, что мы надеемся просуществует еще тысячи лет. Также имеет значение.
So this is one of the few times that I happen to agree with the communist regime. Or at least recognizing your genius.
И вот это тот как раз случай, когда я согласен с коммунистами, да, единственный случай, когда я согласен с коммунистами, которые признали вас гением, создание этого мемориала.
Тадарова.
Окей.
Окей.
Thank you, Lenny. Thank you very much.
Вы сегодня видите мое творчество, надо уже отдохнуть от меня.
You may have rest from him. Let's go.
The visit to the Katyn Memorial was, I think, both a little bit of a shock to us, because we really were only thinking about the tragedy for the 6 million Jews that were killed, forgetting that among them, that also the Belarusian people also suffered along with them, with 25% of Belarusian Jews killed. So with almost a million Jews here and a million Belarusian non-Jews, they suffered greatly. It's still a good reminder for us that although our people have had a great tragedy, it's unfortunately been shared by other people.
Bonnie Frankel, my aunt, and her husband, Larry Frankel. And all of my cousins. As appreciation for your time spent with us today and your busy schedule, we brought from our hometown, Cleveland, Ohio, a book of our city, and a music from our orchestra. My brother, Lipan, he will say a few words. These are Jewish books. It hopes that people in the community can learn from some of the Jewish culture. We also commend you on what great developments have taken place in such a short period of time in the city. We appreciate the open minds and the open hearts that you have. As you said, your grandfather told you stories of what happened in the past. It's our hopes that these stories will be passed on for several generations forever. We also have a cousin who is from Kobrin. And I'm going to ask my Uncle Bobby to mention a little bit about our cousin.
Thank you, Lynn. Besides my cousin, my grandmother, Gloria,
My grandmother was born here.
Его бабушка была родилась в Кобрине.
Lee speaks of a Kobriner, Bob, or Baruch Kanzipur.
Kanzipur.
Baruch Kanzipur and his family were put into one of the ghettos. He escaped. He escaped from the ghetto and went into the forest. And joined a partisan group. Jewish and non-Jewish. They fought the fascists throughout the war. And during this time, most of the partisans were killed. He was one of the survivors. We had planned to come to Kobrin with him now. But unfortunately, he passed away just 2 months ago. He was going to come with his daughter, but because of her father's death, she just didn't feel up to it ready. So we are here to see our family roots. And also in respect to our cousin, Baruch
Kanzipur.
And when we return back to Cleveland, we will tell his family what we saw. And what we heard. And hope that we can return to Kobrin with his three daughters and his wife. Once again, we are very honored, Mayor, to be here. And we understand you put off your vacation for a short period of time.
Они понимают, что вы отложили свой отдых или отпуск на какое-то короткое время, да?
And we appreciate it very much.
Большое спасибо за это.
We are also here to help with the garden that you are planning.
И они также приехали сюда, чтобы помочь с садом, который вы собираетесь здесь, с парком, который вы собираетесь разбить.
And we would like to find some time to discuss that with you.
И они бы хотели, если возможно, обсудить вот некоторые вопросы, касающиеся этого парка.
And we have already prepared a sign to be dedicated at the place where you want your garden.
Посвященный тому месту, где вы хотите садить парк. Вот это вот надпись.
Can you read it?
All these trees were planted in good memory of the family of Bob Kanzipur and other Jewish families of the city of Kobrin, which became the victims of Holocaust during the Second World War. It's a present from the family of Charlotte and Leo Goldberg, July 26, 2000.
Thank you.
Bobby, you want to explain what's going on here?
We're in Belarus, part of Belarus that was formerly Poland. And we want to make sure that nobody on this trip starts like our family starts. Yes. So we have to feed them. And the best thing to feed our family is salami. It's got a lot of cholesterol in it. And it keeps us going for months.
Brenda would have been here, she would have gotten her having down.
Got some buds. And Josh had the beef jerkies. Where are the beef jerkies?
piece of sweet.
Wait a minute, please.
And bean dip when we really need to have a party.
She's for cocktail. She's for cocktail.
Here.
I don't even mean when I ever move on to bean.
No, I just want to get rid of it, but I don't know if you put it back.
Save this.
How is it, Joyce?
We don't know how to pull it.
You having a good time? Bonnie would be so proud of you. Yes, one family went to Brazil.
And
one family left and went to Brest.
And
Brest. And unfortunately, one family, part of the family, stayed in Chunyan and perished in the Holocaust. Along with my great grandmother.
Maybe you have any idea about the house. Where was the house? Where is the house?
At the end of the road was the blacksmith. And there was no house there. Something that's respectful. And we understand that the exact spot where the Jews from this community were murdered, there is currently no marker. On the history, if the families that were murdered there, if their bones were ever moved across the strait.
And it's still untouched, as it was before. There was nothing. They never took anything out and buried it again. No.
Well, we thank the local authorities for giving us the ability to put some small monument to mark the spot. Thank you. Спасибо. Thank you. Спасибо. And until 12 o'clock. And does he know how many lived here before the Second World War?
Library, you can find some records about the situation before the war.
And where is this library?
Uh,
quite close to this house. Across the street. Across the street there is a library. Next to our bus.
And is the library open?
What, do you need more here? No, I have them. You want them? I have them in this room.
Can think of the name.
I think he died.
Natasha, can you ask?
А він умер, його не маєш.
Ah, Grisha.
Natasha. Умер, умер.
And what about him?
One of them died.
Okay,
what about her?
А вот это вот бабуля.
Нету.
Нету, умерла.
Also died.
Тоже улицы фотографируют.
It's you, I think.
No.
Yes.
Yes.
Это вы вас тоже сфотографировали. Идете по улице. Вот вы. Видите? Это вы, да, все вместе.
Ой, уже снова фотографируем.
Tapiro. For you.
Видишь?
Oh, it's for them.
Для вас на память. Для вас на память.
Great.
Now we'll do karma.
Like these husband and wife?
A kind of scout club here, and the scouts are doing research going everywhere, they are collecting all the information about the people who took part in the war, who were partisans, who were in the army, and what they managed to get after they put it on this place.
Музей, вот так говорить, был оборудован в другом помещении. Ну, в связи с тем, что началась информатизация, предмет информатики, и вот внесли сюда, и в этом году был оборудован отдельный зал под музей.
So it's a kind of school museum. It's not finished yet. They have just started to arrange
Здесь, в этом зале, у нас размещены стенды, посвященные мирным жителям, которые участвовали в годы Великой Отечественной войны на фронтах, и стенд партизанского отряда имени Фрунзе.
So we have 1,418 days of war, and the people who all kinds of who take different activities during the war. Nowadays, I don't know how to say it, was working, but it was very active. The partisan detachment named after the great revolutionary Frunze. And when they celebrated the 40 years anniversary of the date of the creation of this partisan detachment, they started to collect different information and open this museum.
Yes, no. В стендах имеется схема расположения боевых действий отряда имени Фрунзе.
And that's the scheme of the activities of these partisan detachment.
Партизанский отряд имени Фрунзе базировался на территории Малорицкого, Кобринского, Брестского и Жиденковских районов. А штаб отряда находился в деревне Павлополь, нашего Чернянского сельского совета.
So it was a rather big detachment, and the partisans were from the whole area. But the headquarters of this unit was here in Chernyame.
Всего за годы Великой Отечественной войны, 1941 по 1945 год, на фронтах, партизанских отрядах наших мирных жителей, нашего колхоза, погибло 54 человека.
Это из партизан, да?
Это участники Великой Отечественной войны, фронтовики и партизаны.
So all in all, a lot of people, most of the people took part in very active during the war year. Some were partisans, some were in the army, and 54 people were killed, died, perished in the war.
А в годы Великой Отечественной войны?
From this area, 54. Were burned, killed, shot in this area by the Nazis.
Здесь на этом стенде имеются все фамилии погибших.
And on this stand, you can see the names of the people who died during the war years. From this area.
Is the name Goldberg there?
Shall I put that? No, just Jews.
Most of them are native people. No, they lived in Chernyame. They were killed.
Here are no names.
Good point. Okay, that's a good picture.
The people who were awarded different medals and orders of the Great Patriot of the Second World War. We were in Brest Fortress, and many families of the defenders of the fortress were brought here and shot here in this area, and they have a burial place here, their graves, not far from this village.
Ask him if he would like.
And to find any possible information about the people, if you give the names,
okay.
About their activities here.
Where do they have
he's ready to support you and to help you and to make a stand here in this.
Where do they have the record? Does he have the records of where he would do the research?
Sorry? No, it's in the library.
Where he would do his research?
He says that he is ready to put another stand, additional stand, dedicated to the Jewish
unfortunately, I only know about my
when all this happened. And he even saw, he was a witness, he saw when these people were taken to be shot.
Helen, we have many questions. Does he mind?
Yes, yes, of course.
Maybe he could first tell his history, memories.
So when
he was a little boy, he was... He was taking care of the cows, yeah? He took the cows shepherd. To the field. Shepherd, he was a shepherd. And he was a shepherd as a little boy.
Mm-hmm.
And then he saw a big German car. He was standing near the road, and the car, the big truck was passing him.
Я познал этого парня, который вместе со мной ходил, и сестру его, они близнецы.
Они были в машине.
Да.
And he recognized two twins, a boy and a girl, in the car, because they went to the same school and they were in the same class.
этого хлопца называли Миша, а сестренку его Грума.
They were Миша, the name of the boy was Миша, and the daughter, the name of the girl was Хрума. And they were sitting on the back bench of the lorry. And then he noticed a fascist SS man from both sides of these two children. And a big dog, two Nazis and a big dog.
Даже километра не было.
So they and he know he saw that the car moved about 1 kilometer forward. It was the place where the people were shot. And then he heard shooting. The noise.
На второй день, понимаете, ну вот туда стали идти мужики.
And the second day he met some people from this village, and he asked people asked them, where have you been to? What did you do there? And he they told that we were making graves, and we were not making, but they were already the bodies, and they had to cover the graves.
He was covering.
No, not he, but he saw the men who were coming back from there. And it was, so it was not so much soil there, ground, and they saw the blood which was coming out of the land. And so they had to dig round again to cover these blood spots. And if you come there, you can see, you'll see these small ditches which were made the second time when they had to cover, the blood. That's what he had seen.
Но мужчин, мужчин взяли раньше.
First were taken the men.
Чтобы попали ямы.
To make the graves, to dig. So first they dug the graves for themselves.
А на семью, на детей, на детей, на жен. Немцы останавливали людей на другой, была гмина немецкая, которые минусы. Останавливали людей, из Чернян попал один человек. Тоже заставили их эту яму.
Сейчас скажем, да,
So
the men, the males dug the graves themselves, and then the Germans stopped the people who were going passing the road, and took them all and brought them there and made them to dig the graves for the families.
Вот мне рассказывал мужчина, который рыл эту яму. Говорит, мы вырыли яму, немецкий офицер прыгнул в яму, вынял пистолет в 4 угла на кресло, расстрелял.
And one man told him, the man who was digging the grave, he told him that when they made the grave, the German officer jumped down there and shot in all four corners, shoot there. And in the afternoon, they started killing the people.
А хозяин, который там около дистаба, там школа была царская еще при царю построена.
And not far from that place,
there was a school
for children. And there was the Gestapo, do you know what it was? Mm-hmm. Gestapo headquarters.
И он через дорогу жил, говорит, я смотрю, минут это евреи. Говорит, пригнали всех туда.
So, and the man who lived not far from there, he said that he saw how all the Jewish people from this area were brought there.
Вышел офицер, вычитал приговор.
So the officer, the German officer went out of the house, took the list, and read them. Приговор как?
Murder.
Ну, kind of all. The women and children started crying. But they put them all. They made them all to get on the truck, on the lorry. And they were taken away and then shot. So it's very difficult for hard for him to tell these stories because all are human beings and it's he never forgets such things. It's impossible to forget what he heard and what he saw.
Did anybody, did any Jews escape from this village?
Yes.
Yes,
Lira. Yes, Shaiko Sil.
Ah, that's Shaiko. We saw the name there on the stand.
No.
And his son, he escaped.
Он находится в
Шайко, the blacksmith?
He's a blacksmith. Он был кузнец?
Кузнец.
Yes, да. Шайко, the blacksmith. Кенигсберг,
да? Да.
And now he lives in Königsberg.
Я не знаю, жив он или не жив.
He has no idea whether he is alive or not.
Он приехал после войны сюда, потому что он инженера учился.
So he came here once after the war.
Почему? Вы не убили?
Не. Он в оккупации. Потом вошел с русским, но в оккупации не попал.
At the time when the war started, he was not here because he was a student and he studied for engineer somewhere away. So he was in the army and he wasn't here.
Он пришел с армии уже, перекрестился на христианскую веру, взял сырьянь.
When he came here, he was Christianed, and he found a good girl from here, married her, and his wife is also from Chernyane, from this place, and he lives.
Він Зіско звався.
You spell his
Зіско.
Захарій.
А по нашому вже Захарій.
His name was Зіско, and when he was Christianed, he took the name of Захарій.
Can you spell that name?
Zahari? Yes, I can.
Sure. I'll spell it for the video.
I'll do it.
Fishman.
Yes.
Fishman
lived
somewhere here.
Over there?
Over there.
He was a very important person.
Who is
in the village. I think he was very wealthy and everybody knew him.
Он был богатый человек.
Коммерсант.
Yeah?
Коммерсант.
He was kind of merchant or trader.
Right.
He was building
in lumber.
Lumber houses. Yes.
Can you spell the name of the person that survived?
Yeah.
How do you spell his name?
Can you spell it for us and
spell the name?
Zisko.
It's his name, Zisko.
Shaiko.
Shaiko. It's his family name. Shaiko, S-A-S-H-A-I-K-O.
And his first name?
Zisko and Zahari.
Zisko Zahari.
Zisko Zahari.
Spell Zisko.
S-I-C-K-O.
Okay, and spell Zahari.
C-H-A-R-Y.
Okay, and how many days after the war began did the Germans come to Chernyanye?
Maybe in two, three days after the war broke out.
He says that on Sunday
the war broke out and on Monday the Germans were already here.
Крепость там обороняли, а фронт пошел сразу.
The fortress was defended, but the Germans were here the next day.
Без никаких этих.
Possessions of the Jews, in their homes, their things.
She says the Germans burnt
Полицаи рассудили.
No, the policemen and local authorities took it.
Те, которые там прислужники были, такие забирали.
So the people who collaborated with the Germans and who helped them, and the policemen, local policemen, they took it all.
Were there any?
And after that, all their wives were, there was a big fight among their wives because everybody wanted to take as much as possible. Yeah.
Did any of the Jews give to their non-Jewish friends their
Oh, maybe they did, but it's a big secret nobody told about it.
Why did they think the Jews were being killed? Why the Jews? Why were the Jews being singled out to be killed?
In their thoughts, why?
А как вот жители деревни думали? Что они думали? Почему вот убивают, расстреливают именно евреев?
А евреи сказали: нами начнуть, а вами закончить.
The Jews told the people that they'll start with us, with the Jewish people, yes, and after that your turn will come.
Так расстреливали русских, вот которые жены военных.
Not only the Jews were shot here, also the wives of the Russian soldiers, of the fortress defenders. Quite a lot of Russian people were shot here too.
Вот памятник стоит вот у нас, там же сарай сожгли и живем сожгли. Вот где вот возле местные жители.
We may go and see them возле
асфальта.
Here, not far from here, you can see the memorial.
Тоже
where a lot of Russian people also were brought there and burnt alive.
And as Verset said, his family, Weiner.
Weiner. Mm-hmm. Did you remember the Goldberg?
Bobby.
He just asked who remembers Goldberg.
He said Weiner's, Goldberg's.
And you worked together?
That was Goldberg.
Это Goldberg?
Да. Вот как раз они.
Хайка.
А я ее не помню, как звали ее.
Ицхак.
Кого вы помните из Гольдбергов?
С Гольдбергом у него было две дочки.
Two daughters.
И он и жена Гольдберг, Виктор.
Виктор Гольдберг. А, звали.
No.
Это другой Гольдберг. Наверное.
Это как, другой.
Какие годы вы помните?
Они, видимо, с какого-то, с года дочки были, наверное, с года... 29-30.
From 29-30.
Как обратите, раз, Гольдберг. Еще и второй был Гольдберг.
Another Goldberg was, he says.
Старый.
Ну, как его звали, не помните, кто у него был?
Мы называли Ерохим его.
Ерохим Гольдберг. Old one.
Ицек.
It was Ицек also.
То... Того не Гольдберг, кажется, фамилия. Ицек, Лейба,
Goldberg.
Does he know Ицек's mother's name? Does he know his mother's name?
Знаете имя матери Ицека?
Ицека не.
No.
Хая or Хайки?
Она старая была.
He was an old lady. She was an old lady.
What did she look like?
Как она выглядела?
Братья были.
Ицек,
Лейба.
Ицхак, Лейба.
И Дина, их сестра была.
And the sister Дина.
Не, Итка. Дина. Дина то
Дина
была
Ицхак
другого.
Дина была дочка Ицхака?
Ицхак это да.
Не, его Сруль.
Марба Бушенгел.
Сруль?
Да, Сруль.
Сруль Гольдберг.
Ага.
Сура?
Сруль. Израиль.
А Гольдберг, как же было Ицка Гольдберг, это сапожника?
Шумейкер вас? One of them?
Well, could be,
вот сапожник был Ицек еще, вот я не помню.
He lived next to the blacksmith.
Фамилия. Он жил около соседа кузнеца был.
Да.
него дочка была Итка.
He had a daughter, Итка.
Не, Итка, правда? Дина.
Посмотрите, может, вы кого-нибудь помните из них?
Look at the other page, too.
Oh, this?
No.
Hi's picture.
Или сейчас на него покажу другую фотографию. Вот эту женщину помните?
Это
не очень хороший снимок.
One on the other page is better.
Или, может быть, этот самый.
It's the same one.
Нет, тот самый. Не помните ее?
Я женщин меньше, мужчин как-то я больше знал.
He mostly remembers the men, not women.
We understand.
Okay, let me just ask him. All right, Yitzhak was married to Tzeltsa.
Yitzhak был женат на Цельце.
And had a son, Label.
У него был сын Label.
Yankel.
Яков.
Малка.
Дочка Малка.
Zara.
Сара.
Шейндл.
Шейндл.
Дина.
Дина.
Дина, то Ицка сапожник был.
And then Дина.
Дина.
And then Моше.
Моше, Миша.
Миша.
Не помните?
Хершел.
Гершел, не помните?
Гершко был кузнец, помню такого.
Блэксмис. Гершко, СС.
Это сын Лейбе был.
He was son of Label.
И Лейба был кузнец.
And Label also was a blacksmith.
Элли?
Элли, помнишь такое?
Элли был.
Yes,
это Фишмана. Фишмана.
Фишман? Yes. Family was related to Fishman.
Да, он действительно был родственник Фишмана.
What does he know about the Fishman?
Что вы помните о Фишмане?
Ну, из них, значит, было как-то Иосиф, кажется, як-то в Фишмановичку от Сюрки звати було чоловіка.
The husband of Сюрка.
Не.
Мошка, кажется.
А не.
Мошку убили на перед.
Еля був такий, Еля.
Ask him what his name is, so we can ask.
Абрамко.
Абрамко.
То Абрамко убили.
Describing who was killed there. Абрамко.
І Сюрка була, сестра.
Об'ясінець його звали, що хотіти сказати, чи по вуличному, чи як, об'ясінець. Він в магазині, тільки от магазині.
Як вас зовут, скажіть, пожалуйста?
Іван. Воробчук Іван.
Іван Воробчук.
Еля був, Йосель був. Йошка був, кажеться.
Everyone had nicknames.
Їх теж в них там було.
Ну, в них це сестра була.
And one they called Abyssinians, Ethiopian.
Сюрка.
Сюрка, я знаю, що Сюрка. А мужик є.
Abyssinians його звали.
Приймак є. Приймак до Сюрки.
The husband of Сюрка, they called Ethiopian.
Були браття.
Браття.
Он був темний, этот Abyssinians?
Темний.
He was dark one, yeah.
А вони всі такі світлі, жилаті.
And others were bright, yellow hair. And this one was Ethiopian, they called him. Abyssinians.
Does he remember what Yitzhak, what kind of business, what kind of, what is trade, the trade of Yitzhak?
Чем занимался Ицхак? Какое ремесло у него было? Или торговля? Чем он занимался?
Кто?
Ицхак.
Ицко.
Ну, смотри, один был, то сапожник был.
One was shoemaker, а второй?
А второй, вот если взяти срульку, видите, кто он так, там, купил что-нибудь, там, как продал.
Коммерчант.
Were they killed in Чуняне, or were they taken to Дивин?
А уже.
Их убили в Чернянах или взяли в Дивин?
В Дивин.
Because they were crazy.
И там Лейфка был, другий. И той, что в школу Мошка ходил, третий.
И цика убили. Этого Срулькова Черняна.
Сруль был killed in Черняна.
Вот тут много расстрелял.
Мошко, это Мойша.
Но их перевозили прах вот на курган туда дальше.
Никто их не возил.
They're now discussing the question, taken from here, from this place, to here or not.
Ask him, tell him if you'd like to come on the bus with us. We're going back to Chunyan. We can drop it in the city. We can keep talking.
Они сейчас едут обратно в Черняны.
We have a half hour to get back there and just go to the archives.
Ну, я могу подъехать, я переоденусь.
He must change his clothes.
No, I haven't.
Why?
You
cannot. It must change clothes.
Okay.
All right,
I think we should get out.
So. Mimi, Mimi and the friend, Mimi and the friend. Mimi, just a little bit. I know it's kind of
Oh, beautiful.
Okay. Wait, we gotta have another picture, please.
All right.
Oh, she spent a lot of time picking those letters.
Hold on. Okay.
Say Daspidani.
Daspidani.
Это должно проявиться. Держите только, вот за это, и постепенно это проявится. Пальцами не надо трогать, да? И она появится также вот эта карточка.
Oh, it's that nice, beautiful dried mushrooms.
Всего хорошего, она говорит вам. До свидания.
Okay.
Встретимся, скажи.
We'll meet again.
Oh, yes. Обязательно. For sure.
Обязательно.
In your house we go.
В вашем доме.
Мы были, они были наши. Мой дом тут там.
Сейчас,
I was there one time, right. Yeah, okay, bye.
Еще раз большое спасибо. Все хорошо.
Спасибо вам большое. До свидания.
До свидания. Будьте здоровы. Чтобы все у вас хорошо было.
Самое главное здоровье.
Здоровье. Здоровье. Здоровье. Здоровье. Здорово стоит, чтобы приехать.
Дорогие друзья, немножко внимания.
Папа, шакет.
Хасахти, что ты моешь реакция от Аба Регель, но я вижу, что есть лихам הרבה מאוד энергия. Аз нисмах, אם תנצלו את האנרגיה, להשתתף איתנו בשיעור.
No, Noga, she is the representative of Jaffi here. And she exactly now is going a lesson of Jewish tradition. So she asked to tell you that she invited you to participate in this lesson. Noga как раз сейчас находится во время урока по еврейской традиции, и она пригласила гостей участвовать в этом уроке.
השיעור לא בעברית, השיעור ברוסית, כי לאנשים מקומיים שלומדים בברס. יש לנו פה אוכלוסייה
נוער ומבוגרים שלומדים עברית, מסורת והיסטוריה, כמו שסיפרתי לכם במינסק, שם גם כן הייתי, עכשיו אני איתכם בברס, וזה המורה שלנו ולודיה.
לודיה, אתה רוצה שאני מתרגם?
כן, דקה. הוא יעביר לנו את השיעור. בקצר, בבקשה.
Преподавание идет на русском языке, поскольку это предназначено для жителей Бреста, для молодежи, для подростков, для взрослых. И Володя – это ваш учитель.
Это что?
Володя is a teacher, and the lesson will be go in Russian, of course, because people just started to learn Hebrew, and they are not very well acquainted with this language yet. So Володя will learn them. We'll teach them in Russian.
Бывакаша, Володя.
Это когда общность между нами, да? Почему собираются люди? Наверное, есть рабочие собрания, есть разного рода собрания. Сейчас, наверное, нас объединяет что? Все мы так или иначе относимся к еврейству.
Не очень понятно, что ты говоришь. This meeting is very important for all of us because here what unites us, we are quite different people of different jobs, of different, everything is different, but the only thing which unites us, all of us are Jews.
Одни собираются стать гражданами Израиля.
Some people are going to leave this country and to live in Israel.
Есть те, которые просто интересуются еврейской историей, еврейской культурой.
And some people are not have no idea to leave the country, but they are interested in the Jewish history and Jewish culture.
И к нам приехали гости, которые хотят узнать про нашу жизнь, про нашу еврейскую, так сказать, восстанавливающееся еврейство.
Some people came from the United States just to learn.
Значит, в этом году, значит, чтобы помочь тем людям, которые интересуются еврейской культурой, которые хотят идентифицировать себя, будучи по крови немножко евреями или более или менее евреями, хотят идентифицироваться, то есть хотят узнать о жизни, о культуре, о традициях еврейского народа.
There are quite a lot of people here in Belarus who live in different culture, but they would like to know as much as possible about Jewish traditions, about Jewish culture and the Jewish education and all such things.
С этого года мы начинаем преподавать, уже преподавали в этом году, помимо иврита, языка иврит, традиции. Традицию, историю и культуру еврейского народа.
We have a school here, and here we teach not only Hebrew, we are teaching the traditions and the culture of the Jewish people.
Надо сказать, что наши праотцы, наши предки, наши евреи, которые были изгнаны с территории Эрец Исраэль в Галут, проявили очень большую волю, большую настойчивость в сохранении своего я, своего еврейства и умении жить по Торе и жить по еврейским традициям.
The ancestors of the people, of the Jewish people living here in Belarus, did their best just to preserve, to keep the old Jewish traditions, the old Jewish culture, and to give it to their children.
Нам приходится в странах СНГ, в бывшем Советском Союзе, где надо сказать, что наши корни, ну, образно говоря, здорово подсохли и, может быть, искусственно искоренялись, простите за тавтологию. Нам приходится начинать с малого.
Here in this country, we have to start such kind of work from the very beginning.
Мы благодарны тем людям в Галуте, которые на протяжении сотен лет, сотен даже тысячелетий, двух тысячелетий сохранили, пронесли через страшные испытания нашу культуру, нашу историю. И хотел бы даже И однажды должна была приехать делегация из Америки в Тель-Авив посмотреть, как все-таки используются деньги, как строится этот город.
Очень длинный, я забыл прошлого вечера.
Значит, люди, помогающие из Америки строить Тель-Авив.
American people helped a lot to build a new city, to do all construction in Tel Aviv. They helped financially.
Они...
It was a very strong wind.
И деревья попадали.
And all the trees fell down.
Поскольку делегация была очень доброжелательна, она понимала трудности.
But the delegation, the American delegation, the members of the delegation were very friendly people, and they understood all the difficulties.
И глава делегации сказал: вот видите, как важно иметь настоящие прочные корни.
The head of the delegation said, you see how important it is to have very good, strong roots.
Вот мы сейчас тоже подходим к этому. Что такое корни? Это изучение...
Thank you.